Good morning, students. This is session 2 on the topic reported speech, under which we did change in imperative sentences in session 1. Let's take a quick review of the rules which we covered in session 1 and then we'll take up the exercise. When your sentence is imperative, rules for changing a direct sentence into an indirect one. The first rule was that the verbs, that is known as the reporting verbs, says, say, or said, will change into tell, order, ask, command, beg, urge, remind, warn, etc. A thing which you have to remember is that while using these words, you have to take care of the tone and the mood of the speaker. In case you're not able to make out the mood or the tone, use the word tell or told or tells depending upon the tense of the reporting verb. The second rule is that in case of a direct imperative, inverted commas are removed and changed into 2 plus V1 in case of assertive sentences. If your sentence is negative, inverted commas are replaced by using not plus 2 plus V1. After the session is complete, children, write these rules in your English language notebook. Now let's do the exercises. Open your BBC book on page 315. Children, as I told you, my book is old. Your sentences may or may not vary. In case they vary, you may skip that sentence and we'll take it up later on. So let's start with the exercise of imperatives. Rewrite the following sentences into indirect speech. Except question number 4 and question number 6. We'll be taking up all the rest of the sentences because these are assertive or imperative or negative sentences. Mind it, while changing the sentence from direct to indirect in case of imperatives, you have to consider the mood and the tone of the speaker. Let's get started. The artist said, "Please pay at the desk." Now the word "please" shows that the assistant is assistant. Please shows that the assistant is making request. So the answer will be, the assistant requested. It's an affirmative sentence, or you can say it is an assertive sentence. So it will be changed to 2 plus B1. My verb is pay. So answer will read like this. The assistant requested to pay at the desk. Let's take up the second sentence. The teacher said, "Listen to me, dear children." Now when she has used the word dear, it sounds that she is not annoyed, she is not angry. So we can simply use the word, the teacher told the children. Now listeners are within the inverted commas, we'll take them out. The children to listen. Now this "me" stands for the teacher, and this teacher can be a male or a female. So the word will be him or her. These are the change in the pronouns. We'll take it up later on because it requires a lot of concentration and focus to understand how the first person or the second person pronoun change according to the listener or the speaker. My grandmother said, "Never mix with bad boys." Now, this is an advice coming from a grandmother, or it can be a warning also. When you read the sentence, "never mix," it's a kind of negative sentence because there's a word "never" in it. So, answer will go like this. My grandmother advised, or you can use the word warned, not to. Rest will be same, mix with bad boys. I hope you are understanding, children. please remain focused while doing the exercise so that every rule I speak is clear to you. Now we'll skip the fourth sentence because it is of a let kind of sentence. We'll take it up later on. First, let us take only assertive and negative sentences in this category. He said to the old man, mind the steps, please. It's a kind of warning because he's walking on the stairs. Steps refers to stairs. So he's asking the old man to take care. So answer could be, he requested, or it can be warning. Sorry, there's a word please. So we'll be using only requested. The old man to mind the steps. We will not use this word please again because we have already used an expression requested for it. Next comes the question number 7. Amrita said to the beggar, go away. Now while saying this, Amrita mood may be annoyed, so we'll go accordingly. Amrita, in case children you're not aware of the mood or the tone of the speaker, you just go with the word told and it is safe to use. It will not be marked wrong. So Amrita ordered. I am taking it that Amrita is annoyed. So Amrita ordered the beggar, as it is a positive or assertive sentence. So it will be V1, 2 plus V1, to go away. Next one, he said, if your brakes are bad, don't drive so fast. Now children, take care of this rule. When there is no listener here, he said to whom, we don't know, so this you or your will change into first person pronouns, that is I, me, my, depending upon what the sentence is asking. So it's a kind of warning, you can say. It's a kind of advice also. Children, I think question number 8 was not could not be seen there as I moved my hand there. So I'll be repeating it. He said, if your brakes are bad, don't drive so fast. Now this person, maybe he's advising or he's suggesting, or you can say it can be a warning too. So accordingly, I will change my reporting verb said. Another thing which you have to take care is, here the word is there, your. Now this your stands for the person who is listening to it. And when the listener is missing, you will change this you, your, or any other similar word to I, me, my, depending upon what your sentence is. So this answer will go like this. He advised or warned. See, read again. If your brakes are bad, don't drive so fast. I can write it in two ways. He advised or warned not to. What was his advice? Not to. Not to drive so fast if my brakes R will change to were bad. Next one. I said to my mother, pardon me. I said your mother is annoyed and the person is saying to forgive or to pardon him or her. I request. Now when mom is annoyed, you can only request her. My mother to pardon me. The next sentence, mother said to Tom, do not play with match sticks. Now it's a warning, kind of warning to the child. So mother warned Tom, do not will change to not to play with matchsticks. I hope, children, you are able to manage with the speed I am speaking. If not, watch the video again. And now let's take a let kind of sentences. For this, you have to come to this page. And as I read the rules, pay attention to what I say. Look here, children. It's a let kind of sentence, and there are two ways of changing. Whichever you feel you are comfortable with, you use that method or the rule. Otherwise, I advise children to go with this one. That is to change the verb into ing. So you must have the knowledge of what is a verb. Verb is a action done. Okay. He said, let us go for a vacation to the hills. Now there are two ways of answering let kind of questions. He suggested, it's a kind of suggestion. So the reporting verb will always be suggested. He suggested that they or we, us will change to they or we, should go for a vacation to the hills. Another way is, he suggested, forget about to whom he is speaking. He suggested, go is my verb. It will change into ing form. He suggested going for a vacation to the hills. I recommend to use this form where the verb changes to ing and we don't have to take care to whom the person is speaking to. I hope you understood. Just read it once again before we take up the questions on the adjacent worksheet. Go with the second option to change the second rule to change a direct sentence, a let kind of direct sentence into the indirect form. Now let's move to the worksheet. We have left two questions. My mother said, let us go to a movie. I'm sorry, my sister said. So answer will be my sister suggested . Now my verb is go here. So answer could be my sister suggested going. Rest is same to a movie. Another one. Ravi said to me, let me go home now. Ravi suggested. Every let kind of sentence is a kind of suggestion. So you will use only suggested. Ravi suggested. Now again my verb is go. I'll take ing form. Going home. Now will change to then. Children, this is a change in the words related to time and place. It's the last table on page 305. You have to read and learn these changes, which show change in words related to or change in words that show time and place. Thank you, children. Complete the worksheet and please read the rules and write the table I have mentioned in the beginning of the session in your language notebook. Thank you, children. Take care.